Welcome to Soul Sessions today, tonight, whenever you're watching this. We are working with herbs today. Herbs, like my sage I always light. Basically, this video is going to give you an overview of the herbs that are great for cold and flu season. If you have a cold, if you have a flu, if you're congested, if you have a cough, sore throat, upset stomach, anything that makes you feel sick, your body just feels sick, upset, like you have a flu or a cold. All right? You're feeling off. These are the best herbs to use in your tea, or you can use it in food, and we're going to go over that. But I'm just here to discuss simply how they're good specifically for cold and flu, and just focusing on that. Now, every herb that I tell you about in this video can be used for so many things. There's so many benefits other than just them being good for cold and flu, but I want to narrow it down and say this is the video for you if you are cold, like if you have a cold. Also, if you're cold, it warms you up as well. If you have a cold, if you have a flu, any symptoms like that, this is the video for you, and these are the herbs that you need to use in your tea. Welcome to my channel. This is your first time watching. Thank you for tuning in. I welcome you into my space. Just gonna get right into it. All right, I have, let's see. Seven. I have specifically seven herbs that we're gonna discuss together. You can use them all together. You can use just one. You can mix them with other things. If you have a specific tea you like, you can pop some of one of these herbs in there with it and have the benefits to help with your cold or flu. Okay. All right, we're gonna start. This is all herbs, okay? Natural herbs that will cure and treat. It will treat your body if you have a cold or a flu, okay? We're gonna get right into it. The first one is golden seal leaf. Golden seal leaf. As you can see, all the herbs that I'm gonna show you, I got specifically from the Enchanted Fae, which is located in Silver Spring. And for a bag this big, I got it for $2.28. It's a really good price because a little bit of this goes a long way. I will be showing you shortly after I go through all of these. I'm gonna show you exactly how I make my tea. I'll do it right in front of you, so we'll do that together too, and I'll show you how much I put in. Golden seal leaf, okay? Golden seal leaf is good for all of the above. Congestion, okay? So respiratory issues, if you're congested, if you have a cough, anything like that. If you're congested and you feel like there's a lot of buildup within you, golden seal leaf is great to break that up, okay? Also, it's good to eliminate parasitic issues. So if you need a really good detox to get that sickness out of your body, golden seal leaf is great for that, okay? All congestion issues and detoxing any parasitic issues within the body. Next, we're moving on to lemongrass. Okay, this is pure lemongrass. This is all pure. And for a bag of this, it was 66 cents. So this is a really great store to go to if you are within the DMV area. It's great. If you're visiting, I would highly advise visit her shop. Lemongrass, okay? Lemongrass is great, again, for fever in general. But it helps boost the immune system. So that's why I'm focusing lemongrass, categorizing it with the cold and flu, because you want to keep your immune system high. You want to build it so that no sickness can live within you. To get that sickness out, this helps build the immune system back up and any fever and congestion problems as well. Lemongrass is great too. The same way you feel about peppermint or eucalyptus, how it like, it's like refreshing, it opens up all the pathways so that you don't feel congestion. Lemongrass is great for that. Next, this is my favorite herb, my very favorite, rosemary. I cook with rosemary all the time. Ladies, rosemary is great for your overall womb wellness as well. So if you want to take care, feminine hygiene, rosemary is really good for that too. And actually, there wasn't a price on this, but again, her prices are really, really good. So I got a bag of this, dried rosemary. And rosemary is great for immune boosting as well. That's why it's in the category of cold and flu, immune booster. Both lemongrass and rosemary are great to boost the immune system. All right, you need that, especially if you feel a sickness coming on or just an everyday tea, or incorporate some of it in your food. Just a little bit will go a long way, okay? Next, we're moving on to, this is something that I have been using, well, both of these, but I've been using this like consistently because it's good for just about everything. But I'll tell you why it's good for cold and flu. Calendula flower. Calendula flower, okay, you guys? It is a flower, obviously, but it's in the daisy family. So think about daisy. Sorry, not daisy. Let me just make sure I'm correct. I did write this down. Daisy's coming to my head, though. It is, actually, it is the daisy family. So think of marigold, those little yellow flowers, spring and summer, they bloom. This comes from that that family. So the beautiful dry petals, okay? Calendula flower is amazing. For me, it's a must have to have in your stock. This was a really good price too for this size. This is a huge bag. This is overall good for everything. I would say calendula and golden seal. These two are amazing for everything other than just sickness and flu. It's amazing for skin. It's amazing for hair, hydration, purifying the blood, detoxing the system. These two are must-haves, but specifically cold and flu, this is great. This is really good as an antiseptic. So this is good to keep your body at its optimum health, honestly. Clean, pure, and it's good for sore throat specifically. So if somebody has a sore throat, calendula flower is great to put in a tea. Sorry, I was trying to shake it up. A little bit goes a long way, okay? Next, we're moving on to elderberry. Elderberry, this is another one that everybody should have. It's good for literally everything. Elderberry, this is pure elderberries. They look like this, little berries. Think of blueberries that hang on a vine, okay? A little bit of this goes a long way. I put maybe four of these at most in my tea because it has a really tart flavor like a berry, and it's pure, so it's really, really, really tart. If you guys have not seen my video, it will pop up. Click on that link. I did a video on how, like, it was a question of how do you treat yourself if you have a cold or flu? Like, how do you fight back, you know? And I have elderberry syrup. It reminds you of Robitussin. So I'll leave that video. When it pops up, click on it. I did a video on the syrup version of this, but this is the pure berry. And it's great to take every day, like a teaspoon a day if you have the syrup. And you'll see in my video what that looks like in the brand, okay? Elderberry is good for like everything. Okay, so elderberry is good. Again, cold and flu. Any cold or flu symptoms, right away do elderberry. Right away do golden seal and calendula. These, you guys, these are your go-to. If you feel a sickness or anything coming on, immediately grab these guys and use them in a tea, okay? Apple cider vinegar too. But this is great for boosting the immune system as well. And any sinus issues, again, it goes with cold and flu, congestion, cough, sore throat, anything like that. Elderberry is what you need. Two more things. This is the sixth herb that I recommend you use if you feel a cold or flu coming on. Eucalyptus. Eucalyptus is great to open up the chest if you're congested, if you have a stuffy nose. It reminds you of peppermint, but to me it's stronger, okay? Eucalyptus is great for fever, congestion, and cough. So it just, in general, helps break up that congestion. This is a great option. Dried eucalyptus leaf, okay? Last but not least, this, I use this not only in teas, but in food. I just hot water with this by itself. I do this with everything almost. Everybody knows what this is. You know what this is. Ginger. Ginger is your like best friend. It's amazing for so many things. That'll be another video. This is all about herbs that I recommend and roots that I recommend for cold and flu. And this is great specifically because it warms up the body. Usually when you have a cold or you have a flu, from my experience, I would get really cold, you know, my immune system was low. So I was very sensitive. I was cold. I always wanted to take hot baths and hot showers, but this helps you sweat that sickness out because it heats your body up from the inside. And coughing, okay? Side note, trip to Jamaica, my husband and I had this cough and it kind of wouldn't stop when we were there. So I looked up online as I was there and it said, ginger and thyme is a great mix as well for congestion or cough. So this will break that cough up, ginger. And it's also good for nausea. So if you feel nauseous and sick, this is great to put a few slices in your tea, to just drink with hot water, to put in food. If you make a nice soup, put some ginger in there. Ginger it's great. If you have any congestion, any nausea, or if you feel cold, ginger is great, okay? That was a quick explanation of the seven herbs that I recommend. These are my highly recommended, and I can say that truthfully because I use it on myself and my husband, and it's worked for both of us. So I'm not just using it on myself. My husband has been treated recently. He just has been, he had this cough and he was feeling really, really tired one day. And then he could have got worse, but immediately I was making him drink tea consistently. He was doing the elderberry syrup version that we have as well, taking a teaspoon a day, taking a shot of apple cider vinegar a day. These things will really help you get through your sickness and treat your body at the same time. So you receive many benefits. If you want an alternative from buying prescription pills just to take, those do a little more harm to your body from my experience than these, and these are natural, and they do wonders for so many different things in the body. I highly recommend doing herbal teas. I'm a fan of that. I do that for my husband as well. So him and I, we do not take over-the-counter medicine, you know, like doctor-prescribed medicine. We treat ourselves at home with our food and natural remedies, and it works. So I'm gonna make my tea, and you're gonna sit here and watch how I make my tea, how much I put in of each, because there's some that I put more of, there's some that I put a lot less because I don't need as much from that. It's very powerful. Be right back, stay tuned. All right, you guys, so I'm gonna show you how I make my tea, and I know you're probably like, we know how to make tea, but it's more so to show you how much exactly I put in there, and yeah, there might be some people that wanna know exactly how I make it, so it's pretty easy. But I use this strainer, I love, and just drop it in my tea, okay? So the three that I chose are the three that are the most powerful to build the immune system, and keep your body functioning at its best. And I want to protect myself from any sickness going around. So, golden seal, calendula, and we have my elderberry, okay? And of course, honey. That's it. That's all I'm gonna do. Now, I said in the beginning of the video, feel free to use your favorite tea mix that, you know, has a really good fruity flavor or anything you love, and just add some of this, any one of these by itself, in with that, and just make sure you add that in addition to what you usually drink. I'm gonna start with elderberry. Told you I just do a few of these because a little bit goes a long way and they're pretty tart. So we're gonna pop these guys in there. All right, so we have the elderberry, calendula, and I kind of just eyeball, and from my experience of making my mixes, I'll know next time, oh, I shouldn't put that much in there. You know, I make mistakes of what I want to taste more of and stuff like that. So I'll do just about that much of the calendula flower. Sorry guys, I'm not a person to say teaspoons or exact measurements. I just do what my body tells me to do and eyeball it and see what works, you know? So just a heads up, you're not gonna get measurements from me, but kind of experiment and see what your body needs, okay? We have that golden seal, I'm gonna put that in as well. And I told you a little bit goes a long way. Some of these are so powerful and the flavor is very earthy. So that's why I said I've made mistakes and I learned not to do as much of that next time. Now there's times where I fill this all the way and it's really, really, really full, but this is all I need. I don't want to waste. Drop that in there. And right here, I have my hot water ready, okay? And now this, I'm letting sit after I mix it all up. I'm letting this sit for about 10 to 15 minutes. You know why? It actually gives it time to brew, time to steep, so that all the flavors really get in there. The flavors soak into the water, so I get all of the benefits and all the flavor. So I just let it sit. Let it blend, let it steep, and I just mix so the honey mixes in there well. That's about it, y'all. I let it sit for about 10 to 15 minutes. And I enjoy, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Enjoy your tea, you guys.